how do you make money?
Well, it's all through sponsorships and advertising, so it's very similar to the TV model. So for Cape Modern, we worked with a bunch of sponsors, Procter & Gamble, MSN, Orange Mobile, Paramount, Buena Vista, who put money in for us to feature products or services as part of the storyline. We try to do it in a way that's as organic as possible, because even though people know that it's a fictional show, we treat it as if these characters are real. Mm-hmm. And so it's as if they actually were using, you know, MSN search as part of the storyline.
Can you stop? It's because I would imagine it would be almost like an addiction, like a dependence.
Yeah,
no, it's like just watching that clip there too. It's like you would become my friend.
Well, that's what happens, and that's for the whole.
That's a hell of a responsibility, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, it is, but then in saying that as well, in Lonely Girl 15, Bree, the main character, she died off in the series as well. But I mean, you know, there is an ongoing relationship, and I really quite enjoy it. I really enjoy talking to the fans as Tara as well, and it's nice because it's created online communities. People, you watch 3 minutes of the clip and that's finished, but then people are in the rooms chatting and continuing the storyline, which you don't have when you watch television.
So what does that mean? What is your involvement like? It must be endless.
Oh, I go on and I check my mail every day. I make sure that I write back to everyone, but it's good. It's not just about the show. I'm writing to people in Middle America about their jobs, about prom, about going to the fun park, about their careers in acting and filmmaking, which is really, I think it's really great.
So how does it work when you're over here with us? Well, you kind of finished filming because
we're
a series.
Her, so we have another copy back home.
Ah, yeah, the idea. Yeah. The idea.
Hang on.
That's a few Charlies.
This is where the plastic surgery comes in.
We have a rolling production schedule. Yeah. Typically, we're a couple weeks ahead with the filming. We're usually 4 weeks ahead with the writing. But it's all very organic and flexible. So, you know, right now we've obviously pre-shot some videos so that we can be here. But we sometimes will film videos the day of and post them.
Yeah.
We've done these live interactive events where the characters will actually ask the fans, come and meet us at, for instance, an art gallery where we had an art show. Mm. And fans showed up literally from all over England. People drove from Manchester like 7 hours to be there and interact with the characters.
It
and
was
you had to be
really
in character.
Crazy. It was like this art gallery, and you've got people there with their cameras because everyone brings their cameras because they want to upload their own videos.
Sure.
And they're going, Charlie, and you... I had to stay in character. I'm like, oh, hi, really nice to meet you guys. Come and talk to me on Bebo. I've seen you on Bebo. That kind of jazz. It is quite surreal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you mentioned earlier, you said you were hoping to break into the entertainment business. So
yeah.
If some big American network comes along and says, all right, Miles, we want this free-to-air TV, can it be done? Would you be tempted?
Yeah, I mean, we already actually had that opportunity. Back in the fall when the press was enormous around Lonely Girl, we kind of took a tour of Hollywood and met with all the big studios. We had some production offers, you know, overall production deals. And we said no and then racked up tens of thousands of debt on our credit cards to continue doing Lonely Girl 15 because we really believed in online entertainment. We really believed in both the creative side of it and then also the business side of it.
So does that mean you would be pushing then for bigger sponsorship to do more online stuff as opposed to mainstream?
Yeah. I mean, we own the shows that we create, so in theory we could do TV shows or movies or merchandising. That's all possible, but really right now we've just been focused on creating new types of storytelling online.
And what about you, Tara? I mean, if Hollywood came knocking...
Don't tempt her.
You're not going anywhere.
I think the question I'm trying to ask is the younger generation, is online the way forward? Mm. I mean, is it going to overtake?
I definitely think it's a growing medium. It's interesting. It's a new form of entertainment. We always want something new. We want something that's, you know, faster, better, more innovative, more interesting and exciting. And, you know, I just look at my younger brother. He's 15. He's mobile phone, computer, talking, having conversations through the computer, and it's a different form of communication. You're sitting this far from what you're watching. We're making friends, we're making online communities. So I think it is definitely, it's a growing medium of entertainment.
It's quite social.
But definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Is there a drawback though? I'm trying to think of cinematic, like the cinematic experience.
Yeah.
Is that a drawback?
I mean, it's challenging. It's there are a different set of challenges for creating an online interactive show. So, you know, the biggest one of all, I would say, is that every video is filmed by a character, edited by a character, and uploaded by that character. That's the illusion that we're creating. Yeah. And so we have to think, why did this character post the video? Mm. What was Charlie thinking when she made this video? And how are the other characters going to respond to that?
Do you think Tara is more at risk of stalkers or people being unusually attached to her any more so than any other movie star or celebrity?
I don't think it's any different than any medium. I mean, the reality is that because of the internet and the world we live in, that it's harder to be private, you know, with our lives. I mean, people are more public with our lives. And I think that especially being an actor, you're just kind of out there for the world no matter what.
Yeah. It's fascinating.
It is. Congratulations to you.
Get online.
Get online.
Kate Modern.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thanks a lot for having us. We appreciate it.